But right now, we're going to go back in time to Spring Stampede. Bam Bam Bigelow and Hardcore Hack. This was a hardcore match for the ages. One more time, back to Tacoma. Bam Bam and the Hackster from pay-per-view.
It was last Sunday at Spring Stampede when Raven's sister Chastity accompanied this man, the King of Hardcore, Hack, to the ring for his one-on-one confrontation with the Beast from the East, Bam Bam Bigelow.
You can see Bam Bam was ready for anything, including coming off the wagon, through the table, Hack leveled Bam Bam, but Bam Bam right back to the eyes of the King of Hardcore.
It would be easier to detail a list of weapons that these two competitors did not use at Spring Stampede. As you see, the ring is filled with everything from ladders to trash cans.
Putting their bodies on the line, Hardcore Hack and Bam Bam Bigelow brought down the house in Tacoma at Spring Stampede.
Well, the battle continued when Bam Bam Bigelow even brought a steel safety rail into the ring. And it was Bam Bam Bigelow in the end scoring the win over Hack.
Bam Bam Bigelow, the Beast from the East, ruled the hardcore division of WCW.
You know, this is a man, Bam Bam Bigelow, who arrived in World Championship Wrestling without a contract. He was intent on making a name for himself in WCW. And Scott Hudson, he has really found his niche. He is the new self-proclaimed King of Hardcore.
There is no question about it. Bam Bam is ready. And if Hardcore Hack wants some more of the Beast, I'm sure the Beast has it ready to give. But right now on Saturday night, it's Bam Bam in the ring. And he is going to be taking on a man who is on the hot streak. The master of the death penalty and the master of the meltdown. He is unleashed on TBS. Get ready for Wrath.
And Bam Bam Bigelow has been on quite a roll as of well. You talked about the match, and we just saw the stills from Spring Stampede when he defeated Hardcore Hack. And then on Monday night at Nitro, it was Bam Bam Bigelow winning a wild kendo stick match against Hugh Morris. And this is really a match, I think, that Wrath has been waiting for. He has been lobbying with the WCW Executive Committee in an effort to get him a more high-profile matchup, more difficult opponents, because we all know that Wrath wants that eventual title shot. And I think that the WCW Executive Committee has heard the tirades from Wrath, and they have decided to put him in the ring with Bam Bam Bigelow.
And I think Wrath can hang with the hardcore contention as good as anybody. We saw that Thursday on Thunder with Wrath and Jerry Flynn. That thing got out of control all over the building in Orlando, and Wrath is right back here 48 hours later in the ring with the Beast.
And Scott Hudson, you think they're dancing in the streets of Atlanta, Georgia after the big announcement that we just had about Nitro?
I'm sure they are. You know, every time we come to the Georgia Dome, 35, 40 grand, they just pile in there. We shoehorn another grand in there just as they buy the tickets the day of the show, Mike. But you got to get them early. July the 5th at the Georgia Dome for Nitro.
And I have just been handed word that tickets are going to go on sale for that event on May the 7th. And we all know what's happened the last two times that Nitro was at the Georgia Dome. We crown new world's heavyweight champions. First it was Goldberg, then it was Hollywood Hogan. Will the streak continue on the 5th of July? What a great holiday weekend that's going to be. World Championship Wrestling back at the Georgia Dome.
Who's going to be world champion come July the 5th? Right now it's Diamond Dallas Page, but look at what he has to overcome, starting with Slamboree, brought to you by 1010-220. It's DDP and Kevin Nash.
And really, if you think about it, Diamond Dallas Page is going up against a man in Kevin Nash who not only has just that World's Heavyweight Championship that he's shooting for, but he's also going to go into the ring as a representative of Hollywood Hogan. And you know that Kevin Nash promised it would be payback Wolfpack style this past Monday on Nitro. Kevin Nash gets that shot at Diamond Dallas Page upcoming on May the 9th at Slamboree. And can you believe this? Tickets are still available at the TWA Dome box office and all the usual outlets throughout Missouri for Slamboree coming to St. Louis. And that's Slamboree brought to you by 1010-220 on May the 9th.
Props to you and the living legend Larry Zbysko, by the way, Professor, on your stellar performance now that you and the legend are co-hosting WCW Thunder. What a night it was last Thursday.
And a quick reminder about upcoming Thunders. April the 29th, we will be in University Park, Pennsylvania at the Bryce Jordan Center. May the 13th in Wichita, Kansas at the Kansas Coliseum. Pick up your tickets now in University Park at the Arena Box Office and the usual outlets in Wichita at the Coliseum Box Office and all select-a-seat outlets.
I gotta wonder, we're watching Wrath and Bam Bam tear it up here on Saturday night. Oh, hang on. Bam Bam with the hot shot on Wrath. Charles Robinson, the third man in the ring. Is he making mental notes in there right now as he prepares for his match with none other than Gorgeous George at Slamboree, brought to you by 1010-220 on May 9th. That's going to be... what do you call him? Little Nate?
Little Nate. That's his nickname.
In the back pocket of the Four Horsemen, taking on the beautiful valet of the Macho Man at Slamboree.
And think of the major impact that that's going to have as Bigelow drops down with the diving headbutt. Because if Gorgeous George wins, if she defeats Charles Robinson, Randy Savage will be reinstated. Two count. And Wrath was barely able to kick out.
When you've got 350 plus of Bam Bam Bigelow laying across your shoulders, it's something entirely just to kick out, even weakly. And Wrath kicked out strong on Bam Bam.
If you think about Wrath's strategy in this match, is he going to be able to use that meltdown against someone the size of Bigelow? You really have to think that that may go into his mind in terms of his pre-match game plan as he prepares for someone the size of the Beast from the East.
And I gotta wonder, can Bam Bam Bigelow get a man the size of Wrath up into the greetings from Asbury Park? Both of those finishing maneuvers rely so much on the power of the man putting the maneuver on. They have never been against someone this big, I don't think. I don't think Wrath has ever attempted the meltdown on a man the size of Bam Bam, and vice versa for the greetings from Asbury Park.
Opportunity now for Bam Bam Bigelow to continue his domination in this matchup, just neutralizing Wrath. And it's been a rarity when we've seen Wrath on the receiving end of so much punishment from his opponent. Fires him off into the corner. Wrath came out with momentum on his side, and he decked Bigelow with the clothesline.
Like a big redwood falling in the forest. He got him up. He got up all of Bam Bam Bigelow with ease. And Wrath is on a roll on Saturday night. From the middle turnbuckle. No! Bigelow out of the way, and Wrath missed the elbow.
Well, the ease that Wrath picked up Bigelow for that body slam, he might be able to get him up for the meltdown.
He may very well. Hang on!
Attack!
Good night with the kendo stick! Pack is in the ring! Oh, there he goes after Wrath! He doesn't care!
No, he's not picking any favorites! Kendo sticks for both men!
The king of hardcore is loose, but there's Wrath! Cut him off in the back of the head. There goes Hack all the way outside. Now Bigelow, and oh, what a back elbow. Wrath all the way back out there with Hack. Now Wrath and Hack pull Bigelow outside. It's every man for himself as these three hardcore maniacs go at it on Saturday night.
It's turning into a three-way brawl as they fight up the aisleway. Everybody just pounding on each other. Hack appears to be on the receiving end in the middle of punches for both Bigelow and Wrath now.
Oh, there's Cassidy.
Oh, there's that fire extinguisher again.
Oh, please. It is breaking down here on Saturday night.